So hello everyone, this is Phoenix Love and we are starting with the Torque tutorial. So Torque is our first robotic event and we are building the basic Roborace cars which will be totally based on the basic electronic circuits. So as you know, every robotic construction have three major parts. One is input, one is processing unit and the third is output. So we will start with our input part, that is our remote. First we will continue with our theoretical concept, then we will start with the instruments we will be using in making the our bot, and then we will be actually working to how to build one bot. So let's start with our remote part. So here is a basic diagram for our remote. For our remote we will be having two DPDT switches, one is this and one is this. So basically we are having four motions. Four motions will be forward, backward. Four motions will be forward, backward, left and right. So for every motions, our motors will be working in consecutive parts. So left part of the bot will be working together and right part of the bot will be working together. We are this concept is called differential drive bot, where the individual tires, both two tires of one side will be working together and the other side will be working together. So this is our this circuit diagram. So we are having we will mark each DPDT for one individual motion. So our first step will be we have to put the DPDTs in switch box. This is digital box. Then we will start with marking. So we will mark this DPDT. The first part will be forward, and later part will be backward. Now the second DPDT switch. So the upper switch will be for left, and lower switch will be for right. Now for each motion, both left and side, left and right part of the board will be moved in some order. So each motion will have forward, left forward, left backward, right forward, right backward, this type of motions. So let's start with what forward will, in forward condition, what will be the motion of the left side and right side. So as we know, in the forward condition, the whole board will be moved in the forward, in forward direction. So we need to have left forward and right forward commands in our forward forward condition. Now similar like forward, we will be having our backward condition, where left part should be backward and right part should also be backward. Okay, so both the left and right side of the board will be moved in backward direction. Now let's get to the difficult part, that will be the left and the right motions, the sideway motions. So we have marked the second DPDT upper part as left and the lower part as right. Now when we consider the left motion, so as we can just imagine that when we are moving to the left direction, so the left part of the bot will be moving backward back direction and the right part of the bot will move in forward motion. So the same thing we will be representing here. Now the left part, in the left motion, the left part of the board will be moving backward direction, so left backward, and the right part of the board will be moving in the forward direction, so right forward. These both commands will be executed when we press the left button of the DPDT. Now we will start with our right motion. So similar like left part, the right part of the board will move in backward direction and the left part of the board will move in forward direction. So we have marked these commands in this DPDT here. So the left part will be in the forward direction and the right part will be in the backward direction. So this is the basic schematics that how each switch should work and give command when one individual motion is required in forward, backward, left and right. But we to make this circuit clean, we will only have four basic commands: left forward, right forward, left backward and right backward. So we don't need to have 8 separate commands from the whole box. So what we will do, we will connect similar motions, similar motion commands from both the DPDTs, and then we will only have four basic commands that we will pass on to the processing unit. Okay. So this we will just connect the left backward with the other left backward, left forward with the other left forward, the right forward with the other right forward, and the left right backward with the other right backward. This way we will complete the connections in our DPDT box. Okay. DPDT and the remote control box. Now we will just need to take some wires and then take the connections out from the left forward. So we will just take one wire out from the left forward side. Now then again we will have the left backward motion. So we will take one wire per wire and connect it to left backward sides of those switches, and then we will take it out. Similar, we will have right forward and right backward. So this way from the input part is completed, and we will have, after completing the remote board, we will have four basic commands that will be left forward, left backward, right forward, and right backward. Okay, so this way we will be having our remote part complete. Now we will come to the processing part, processing unit. So this is our processing unit, which we will be building on PCB, which is zero PCB. So we will come to that why it is called zero PCB, and how to operate with that, and what is soldering, what is soldering paste and all. Now let's just finish with what we will actually be doing with this. So these are the four boxes, and these are relays. Actually, these are relays which we have been covering in the class. Right, left, backward, so four relays. And the actual work of the relays will be to provide the output signal to the motors. So motors will be the motors that will drive our bot to the motions. So this is the whole processing unit. Now relay have basic five pins. Okay, so these are one is for input, one is for output, one is normally closed and one is normally open, and the other pin is ground. So these are basic nomenclature. Now let's see how it actually works. So in the relay we are having an SPDT switch and one inductor. So using that inductor, we operated switch, SPDT switch, and switch from one position to other position. So the switch normally relies on normally closed position. So that we can see here, that output is connected to the normally closed position in normal case. So what we actually want is that when we provide the input, this switch will shift to normally open switch pin. Okay, so this SPDT switch will shift from normally closed position to normally open position, and that way we will provide the output, that is 12 volts current from battery. So now comes that how we will have to orient our PC and orient and design our PCB and the preprocessing unit. So let's start with that. So we will be having four different relays for each individual motions that we have mentioned before. That will be left backward, left forward, right backward, right forward motions. So each relay will operate that each motion. So first we will place these four relays in the PCB. Then we will mark each relay with their particular motion. So just here I have my marked left forward, left backward, right forward, and right backward. Okay. So next we have indicated what is actually the each pin is basic nomenclature, and then when each pin is how to get connected to each other operations. So now What we need to do is we will place this. Now we will be connecting the normally closed position to the zero volt. That way, when we will be in normal position, so the bot will be in off condition. So we will be connect all the normally closed pins, normally closed, normally closed, and normally closed pin to the zero volt. Now comes how we will provide the output. So for that, we will be connecting a plus 12 volt to normally output pin. Plus 12 to normally output position. So plus 12 to normally open position. Okay. So then we will connect our ground to this 0 volt, this last pin to 0 volt, then last pin to 0 volt, and last pin to 0 volt. So this way we have just completed our soldering part. Now what we'll be doing is we will take this individual outputs from the remote, that is step forward, and we will connect it to the relay having relay input, which is relay input, which is marked as left forward. Now then we will take the other command pin, that is left backward command, to the input of the relay, which is marked as left backward. Now similarly we will do this for right forward and right backward. So just take this connect this wire, which is marked as right forward, to the input of the right forward relay. Similarly for right backward relay. So this way we have connected our input with the processing unit, and the processing unit will provide and drive our bot in the for that particular motion. Then we will be pushing forward button. So both left forward and right forward buttons will be connected to this pole. So that way we will be providing plus 12 volt to this left forward wire also, and right forward wire also. So this left forward wire and right forward wire both will have now the inputs that will be plus 12 volts. Then he becomes here. Now the left forward relay and the right forward relay, when the both are having in their inputs plus 12 and plus 12. Now what will they do? They will drive the SPDT this pole to this normally open pin, and this normally open pin, and that way the normally open pin will connect to plus 12 volt, and then plus 12 volt is connected to the output. This plus 12 volt will be connected to the output. So we will got the output for our motors. Now let me just demonstrate, explain the another example. So now if we are having one left command, so what we will do when we press the left, when we press the button which is marked as left, this left backward pin which we have marked is left backward, and right forward pin, both will be connected with this plus 12 volt connection. So this left forward pin will be connected with plus 12 volt, this left backward pin will be connected with this plus 12 volt. Then both these wires have the plus 12 volt current. So right forward will have plus 12 volt, and the left backward will have plus 12 volt. Both this will have plus 12 volt. Now this is our input. This will be passed to this left backward relays, the input. This will be passed with left backward relays with input. And then similarly, the SPDT switch will switch from normally closed position to normal open position. Normally sit closed position to normally open position. This that plus 12 volt is now available with at our output, and this other plus 12 volt is available at our output. So we have now demonstrated two of the motions. Similarly, we can derive it for the other motions too. So thank you for this theoretical part, and then we will continue with the tools.
Welcome back everyone. Now we will start with the tools we will be using in making the dot bot. So the first tool I wanted to introduce is this. This is called a wire stripper or a cutter. So we will be basically using this to strip the wires or cut the wires. So the basic instructions will be to cut the wires, we will be using the lower part and just put it between in and then cut. So this is just a demonstration, and now For stripping the wire, we will be put it between this both two gaps, and we will put apply a small pressure and pull it out. It's a turn for our main, one of the most important tool. This is what we call a soldering rod, and this is the stand for the soldering rod. So take care. Be very careful while handling this. This whole metallic part is very hot when we connect this plug to the power source. So make sure that you never ever try to touch this part when it is hot. Now comes the building material with the, and this is called one soldering wire. Now we will be starting with the other tools that we are going to use in making the torque bot. So the first tool and the very important tool will be a multimeter. So this is a multimeter. There is a digital display here, and there are some this is one knob, and there are other parameters and functions we will be using in with this multimeter. Now the first part, the upper right part, is used for calculating or measuring the voltage. This left part we will be using for measuring the current, and this there are other functions also here. So first thing I would like to demonstrate is the short circuit function. So with this this function, a diode is made here, and one voice like icon. So with this function, we can easily track where is the short circuit in our whole circuit. So these are the two props we'll be having with our multimeter. So when we connect these two props in short circuit mode, a sound is made like this. So this indicates that we are having a short circuit in our current, in our circuit. So we can actually may use this to for calculating other and understanding other tools also. So the next tool we will be seeing is a DPDT. So this is a DPDT, and we are having the 6 pins here, and we are, as we have seen, this is two SPDT connect SPST switches connected side by side. So now we are having this upper switch and then lower switch. So we are having two command switches here, and we are having 6 pins here. So whenever we push one switch, the upper part, like we push the upper switch, so this basic between two pins will be short circuit with this upper two pins or connected. And similarly, when we press the lower button, the basic two pins will be connected with the lower pins. Now let's see how we can detect it with a multimeter. So here we will be using again the short circuit function of the multimeter. What we will do is take this knob and place it in this short circuit option. So I will again show you. This is the short circuit option. Now what we will do is take these two knobs and place one on the upper and place one in the between. So we are seeing we can see that no voice is made even if we are in the short circuit mode. Now when I will press the button, we can hear one voice. I am pressing this button. I'm pressing this button, and we can hear one noise that indicates that the upper and the middle pins are connected when we press the switch. So the next important component, electromagnetic component, which comes is a relay. So as we can see, relay is a 5-pin component, and we have a basic diagram which we have demonstrated in our last theoretical video. So just as we have seen there, we are having one normally closed pin, normally open pin, the output which is in between the lower and in lower part, one input, the in the right corner, right bottom corner, and one ground. So let's see that just to check that if in actually this output and the normally closed pin is connected or not. So again we will be using this short circuit function. Place one knob in the middle and place other in the normally closed pin. Placing other in the normally closed pin. Okay. So we can hear one voice. We can hear one voice when we place one in the bottom and the place of the normally closed pin. So again, you can see here how it is going. Normally closed. Normally closed pin. Now let's see whether the output is connected with normally open or not. So when we press with normally open one probe and other with the output, so as we can see there is no output sound. So this time they are both not connected. So we have now verified that which pin is normally closed and which pin is normally open. Now we will come with the next thing, the power source for our bot, which is this acid lead battery. So this acid lead battery is a 12 volt battery with approx 1 ampere current. So we can also check the voltage that we this battery is how much voltage is having. So we will now use the voltage measurement part of this, and we need to switch to one option that will be that is having the upper limit value than the maximum current this battery can have. So like if this battery can have 1 volt, so we can switch to 2, 10, 20, but we can't measure it in 500 millivolt option. So like this is having 12 volt, so 12 volt maximum output, so we'll be switching to 20 volt option. So now we just need to connect this one probe with one pin and the other with the other probe. Okay, and now we can see that this battery is completely drained. So for so make sure that your battery is charged approx 12 volt so that you can actually drive your bot. So as we again see that it comes to zero when we have removed it. So we will show you the how to charge this 12 volt battery again later. So now comes the other basic components that we will be using. So this is our metal chassis. Metal chassis, as you can see, on which our whole bot will be the platform where the whole bot, the tires and all will be connected. Now comes the tires. So these are our tires. Okay, so we will be placing them in the left and right position and two more in the backward position with the motors, and they will drive the bot. So now comes the motor, the engine, basically the engine of our bot, and this is one motor. So with this motor we are having two inputs. We are having two inputs and this is the one input and this is the other input. We normally mark we normally solder this motors with one wire and the other other pin with the other wire. Now we are with the motor, we are also having one screw. This is one screw, so that we will be placing that we'll be using while placing this motor on the bot. So once just one quick demonstration, we will be having this motor, we are having this screw and we are having this chassis. So place this motor in the chassis and then put the screw. Okay. That way your one motor is completed. So and then we are having one hole in the chassis. So with using that hole, place this, take these wires out of the chassis. So this way we have placed one motor in the chassis, and we have taken the outputs of one motor from the chassis. This way it is much cleaner than taking it from either backward or forward. So now comes the other tools. So this is one screwdriver set. This is not actually recommended, but it will be helpful when we will be using, when we will be placing tires on motors. So just to have a quick look. So this is our screwdriver set. We are having one holder, and we are having different pins for different sets of different types of bolts. So this is one, and there are whole set of bunch of pins we will be using. Now comes the communicator or main channel through which we will be passing our whole signals and power. So this is called a bus wire. Some people call it rainbow wire because of the colors. So normally it will have 10 different color wires, and we will be using them to connect our remote with our chassis. Using this wire stripper to cut the soldering wire, just using the lower part. Now we have a piece of soldering wire. Place the wire stripper away. Now we have carefully take the soldering iron, place, and just apply soldering wire on the pin, and then press it with the soldering iron. So that way the soldering wire melts and get pasted on this pin. Easy way. And as we can see, it just get cooled faster, and now we have a strong bond with this soldering wire. This is a zero PCB, and it has two sides. One is a plain side, and the other, where the other is having some plating of some other material, or it can either have a copper plating. So as you can see, there are many holes, and due to this structure that there are so many holes and no other structures, it is called zero PCB. So all the holes are equal, and we can place it in anywhere. So now whenever we place a component here in the PCB, so make sure that all the connecting parts are on this side, the soldering side, and no other parts and wires and soldering are done on this other side. So it will be a very bad design if you are using soldering and doing soldering on this side. So now comes then how we will be building our bot. So for starters, when we start to build a bot, we can start from the output, then the processing unit or the remote, or we can start from the remote, then processing unit, then the output. So I will start from the remote, and first we will be placing this DPDTs on that is DPDT switches on this remote case. So this is one black colored remote case, and to normally place the DPDT, we will just take one DPDT. This will be hollow, so we will place it inside and press it. So just one demonstration, we will be having this DPDT, we will just press it, and now it is in. So we have marked our switches and each switch with forward, backward, left and right command. So when we press the upper switch, so this will be a forward command, so our bot should move in forward direction. Lower switch backward command, this upper switch is left, and this lower switch is right. So for each right and left, we will be having two signals. For one right, we will be having right forward, right and left forward. For one back, we will be having right backward and left backward. So now comes with the connection part. So we will be connecting inside of the switches pins, the left forward with left forward and right forward with right forward, and we will be just take out four wires from this like this. So this is not now connected actually, but this is just a demonstration. So you will actually need to connect this wire with the this forward wire with the other forward wire, and this way we will take this output. And now this we will connect this this four wires with the bus wire. So now comes the time of the processing unit, the brain of our bot, and the processing that we actually be doing. So we will first, what we will need to do is place four relays, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and first mark them for their work. So that will be right, left forward, left backward, right forward, right backward. Then we will need to place the provide the +12 volt current and the ground current. So for that we can just strip one wire, basically strip one whole wire, this rubber covering, and then place it on this PCB like this, PCB like this, and then we can this can actually act as a supply for 12 volt or either ground that we have used in this connection. So now what we have done here is we have now stripped the whole wire and then used this as a source. This is a source for +12 volt, and now we have also placed here ground wire which will be using as a source for ground. Now this side of the relays, let's just see backward, this relay, and now this side of the relay, this is the normally close pin, and this is the ground pin that we have referred. Now this is the input pin, and the middle one is the output pin. So with this each individual input pin, we will connect those four wires, left forward, left backward, right forward, right backward wires, using the bus wire, and connect it here in each individual inputs. And and we will, after that we will be having four individual outputs that will be from this middle wires for each side. As we know that whole one side of the bot will be working together, so what we will do, we will connect one motor with the other pin. So we have this motor, we will connect this motor pin with the other motor pin using, and we'll make it tight bond using the soldering. Okay, place it in the either plug in this part, and similarly we will be doing is placing two more motors here, connecting both the motors first, and then taking one of the motors output out from this lower part, and taking it out to connect it to the processor. So this way, before connecting the wires, please make ensure that when we provide the output, the both motors will run in the similar direction, not in the opposite direction. Check that using the batteries. So that way, when we will connect the motors with the processing unit, they place this whole built PCB on this processing unit. And use some duct tape or normal tape and place it here. You can also use some paper to place it between this metal chassis and this connection, so that no chances of short circuit will be there. And just connect this with this, and make sure to provide 12 volt battery, 12 volt and ground here. And please, we will also be placing the battery on this battery. Oh, hey. Battery. So we will be also placing the battery on the same chassis, or what we can do is take this battery with our remote, so that the chassis will be light. So for my recommendation, take this battery and place it with your remote, and connect the +12 and ground wire there, So your chassis will be light and you won't be needing, you can easily drive the bot.